So Dr. Vazquez, this week you launched Thought Exchange, which is a platform to get feedback from our community as far as things that are important to them, questions that they would have. Tell us a little bit about that.
Well, Thought Exchange really came about as we were having conversations about how we could share our story, how we could garner feedback from all of our stakeholders, both internal and external. And so we piloted over the summer with our administrators, had tremendous feedback, and now we're using it to connect with our community.
So launching it this week had a lot of feedback around hurricanes. Some of the questions were around the decisions that you make when it comes to closing schools, for example, and when to close them and how long to close them. Can you talk a little bit about that and help answer those direct questions that came in through Thought Exchange?
And I can imagine that the hurricane is top of mind for our parents and our community members. The decision to close schools is one that requires a lot of coordination and collaboration, both with our county administrators as well as district staff. And so we rely on the expertise of those various individuals and teams to look at the trajectory of the storm, the path, and because this particular storm has wavered in its pathway, we've had to make some changes. Originally, we made a decision to close school Wednesday and Thursday and discontinue any after-school activities beginning this afternoon. Based on the changes that we saw overnight, we now have to close school on Friday. And so that is a continued dialogue between both the mayor's emergency management team and our emergency management team.
Great. And can you talk a little bit about the decision points, like buses, for example, being on the road, wind speeds, things like that, that can also lead to making some of those decisions?
Right, and sometimes individuals will question, well, it's sunny outside, why have we decided to not have schools? We cannot operate our buses safely once we have continuous wind speeds over 35 miles per hour. And it's because that safety is our number one concern, we will make decisions to close schools once we know that there is a high probability of having sustained winds above 35 miles per hour.
Good. And can you talk a little bit about makeup days and how those are determined and what goes into the decision making when it comes to the makeup days?
So Orange County is proactive in determining makeup days a few years in advance, and we currently have those days published on our website. But there are other factors that go into makeup days, including additional minutes that might be built into the academic calendar. And Orange County currently has one day that we're able to give. Additionally, we may hear from the state that they are going to waive days as a result of the impact of a storm. And so we will wait to see direction from the state, and we'll wait to see how long we are closed before we make any announcements about the total number of days that we will have to make up.
Any final thoughts about the hurricane?
So I'm so grateful that we do have this platform to be able to push out information to our community as well as hear what's on their minds. Going through a hurricane is something that causes a lot of stress and anxiety, and if we are in any way able to reduce that by providing them accurate information and pointing them to resources, then I'm thrilled, and I hope that they will continue to take advantage of the Thought Exchange to let us know other topics or other questions that they may have about Orange County Public Schools.
And one more thing, how can they find out more information about hurricane preparations on the district side? Where can they get that information?
So we will continue to update our families through our Connect Orange messages, through email, through our website, through social media, and then they can also go to Orange County's site where they will have information listed there, shelters, resources that are available to them.
Well, that's great. Thank you, Dr. Vazquez, for allowing me to sit on your couch on your set.